If you don't have an account at a credit union, I highly recommend you to open one up. Whether it's your local credit union or one that's nationwide, just make sure you do your research. Take this walk with me. What is up, team? It's your boy Sledge from the Sledging Team back with another video. And today, we're going to be talking about some things that Navy Federal isn't likely to tell you unless you ask them. And you know over here at Sledging, we get straight to business, so let's get to it. Since you're watching this video, you probably know that Navy Federal is the largest credit union in the nation. And they're known as the House of High Limits because they can give generous credit limits, sometimes even to people with fair credit. But here are some things that you may have not known about Navy Federal. Number one, after you've had a credit card with them for at least 6 months, their computers look at your credit history to see if you're eligible for automatic credit limit increase. Even though you can request a credit limit increase after 90 days or 3 statement periods, this still applies. But one thing to know is, a credit limit increase is not guaranteed. Another thing that I found out is that there could be a lock on your cards that will prevent you from being reviewed for a credit limit increase. And after I did my research, I found out that the Navy Federal reps most likely will not tell you why the lock might be in place on your account. But the only way to get it off is to either call or by secure message. Your boy's account was locked. And the only reason I found out is because when I came across this information, I called to see for myself. Number two, you can move credit from one card to another. This is called credit reallocation. So if you have two or more Navy Federal credit cards, you can call and have them reallocate part of your credit limit between the two cards. So say you have a 10K Gold Rewards card and a 4K Cash Rewards card, and you want to reallocate part of the credit limit from one card to another, just call Navy Federal and they'll do it for you. This isn't something that's exclusive to Navy Federal because I've done it with American Express and I've heard that you can also do it with Chase. So I would think that it probably works with most institutions. But one thing to know about Navy Federal is this only works with their personal cards. Number three is you can product change your cards, meaning that you can change from one card to another by simply giving Navy Federal a call. You have to have your card for at least 12 months before you can do this. And since Navy Federal only has one business card, you can only do this with personal cards. The only personal card that could be an exception to the rule is the Navy Federal flagship card, and the reason is because that is a Visa signature card. To be approved for a Visa signature card, you have to be able to be approved for a minimum of $5,000 credit limit. So in order to product change to the flagship card, you must have a Navy Federal card that has at least a minimum credit limit of $5,000. And for the people that have the M Rewards secured card, your card has to become unsecured before you can do a product change. But the good thing is, more than likely, you will get a credit limit increase once it does become unsecured. And if that credit limit increase brings your credit limit to 5K or more, guess what you can do? Yes, you can product change now to the Navy Federal flagship card. Disclaimer, do understand that if a secure card becomes secure, you still have to hold that card for a year before you can product change it to another Navy Federal credit card. Also, if you go the route of product changing your cards, you will not be eligible for the sign-up bonus, so make sure that you keep that in mind. But if you don't mind not getting the sign-up bonus, and when you pre-qualify for your Navy Federal credit card, do your research on pre-qualifying for any card that allows you to pre-qualify to give you the best odds of approval. Even though pre-qualification isn't 100%, it still allows you to get your best odds of approval. But here's a way to get a higher tier Navy Federal card like the flagship or the More Rewards card, even if you don't pre-qualify for them. If you pre-qualify for a card that's easier to qualify for, such as the Gold Rewards, the Cash Rewards, or the Navy Federal Gold Card, but you want the flagship or the More Rewards, you can get one of those cards and product change to the More Rewards or the flagship down the line. Another thing is for my people that like to keep balances on their card from month to month. After 12 months of holding an unsecured Navy Federal card, you can call in and request for them to lower your APR. Now, they might lower it 1%, they might lower it 5%. I'm not sure. But after you hold the card for 12 months, just give Navy Federal a call, and most likely they will lower your APR as long as you've been using the card responsibly. Now, here's the last thing that I think you should know about Navy Federal. Now, Navy Federal is a great institution with great products and great cards. But one thing about them, their communication can be trash. It's not trash, but it can be trash. Their communication is often delayed, so you might have to check the app or call and check up on credit card applications, credit limit increases, and so on. When I requested a credit limit increase on my More Rewards card, which was my first Navy Federal card, I was denied that increase. I waited over a week for a response before I finally called. The reason was that Navy Federal had extended the max amount of credit that they could extend to me at the time. My starting limit for the More Rewards cards was $25,000, and I asked for an increase to $33,000. This was before I started my channel, and I didn't do the proper research. I was going off what other credit card YouTubers were saying about getting a credit limit increase after having the Navy Federal card for 91 days. What I found out was, you can get a credit limit increase in 91 days, but that 91 days has to fall within 3 statement periods. Mine didn't, and therefore I was denied. When I called to inquire why I had been denied, I explained to the rep that I had waited 91 days before I requested the credit limit increase. This is when she explained to me that it's 91 days and 3 statement periods. So if you are not sure, I recommend that you wait at least 100 days before you apply for a credit limit increase. I never reapplied for that credit limit increase, but you know your boy. Right after that denial, I applied for the Gold Rewards card and got a credit limit of $11,000. Yeah, I was denied a credit limit increase of $8,000, but approved for a credit card for $11,000, which is now $19,000 because I got a credit limit increase on that card after 3 statement periods. At this point, I have 3 Navy Federal cards. The More Rewards, the Gold Rewards, and the flagship. And Navy Federal has extended $76,000 in credit to me. And based off my personal experience, because you know over here at Sledging, we talk about things from a personal perspective. These are some of the things that you need to know about Navy Federal that aren't commonly talked about. But if you have some more data points, leave them down in the comment section. So if you like this content or was just entertained, hit that thumbs up, share this video, but most importantly, drop a salute emoji in the comment section. And remember, the separation is in the preparation. It's your boy Sledge. Salute.